We next have poster 76, titled Knowledge and Practices on Antipyretics Among Caregivers of Pediatric Patients at Teaching Hospital, Ragama. The authors are Darshika GHI, Ratnayaka HGHK, and Methananda S. The presenting author is Darshika GHI.
Good morning. I am Dr. Darshika. Today I am here to present our poster regarding knowledge and practices on antipyretics among caregivers of pediatric patients at Teaching Hospital, Ragama. Fever is the commonest presenting complaint to pediatric units worldwide. So it is really true with Sri Lanka as well. Here we aim to describe the knowledge and practices of fever and antipyretics among caregivers attending to the Teaching Hospital, Ragama. Here we have used descriptive study in Teaching Hospital, Ragama between June to November 2019, where we have collected data from 495 of caregivers who brought their children above 1 month with fever were recruited, and data were collected using a pre-tested interviewer administered questionnaire to gather information with regard to social demographics, knowledge and practices about fever and antipyretics. An ethical approval was obtained from Sri Lanka College of Pediatricians. As a result, we found out of 495 of caregivers, 84 was females, and mean age was 31.8 years, and they 98 of them were married, and 44 were studied beyond grade 10, and 77 were housewives as their social demographics, and mean age of their children were 35 months, and 7.1% of their children had febrile convulsions before. And we found that 69% of caregivers use thermometers to use or detect fever on their children. However, only 19.4% of them could accurately measure the temperature deciding on fever. Actually, the paracetamol is the preferred antibiotics in 98.4% of them, but some used other antipyretics like ibuprofen, diclofenac, sodium and aspirin and mefenamic acid in addition to paracetamol. Even though now there is a circular calling that in Sri Lanka we can't use NSAIDs in children because of dengue prevalence. And we found that 83% of mothers knew that paracetamol should give according to the weight of child, but only 12% of them could calculate the correct paracetamol dose of their children. And we found that 40% of our caregivers were given supratherapeutic doses of paracetamol to their children. Even though questioning, 90% of them knew that overdose of paracetamol could harm their children, but they have given supratherapeutic doses in 40%. In conclusion, we got that 2/3 of mothers used thermometer to measure temperature, but only 1/5 of them could use it correctly, and 12% of children was given very high doses of paracetamol in the mean of more than 20 milligram per kg per dose of paracetamol in who were cared by male caregivers in particular. So as a recommendation, we need some awareness program regarding the antipyretics among caregivers, same time the in danger of NSAID in a area in a era like dengue in these days. Thank you.
Thank you. The paper is now open for discussion.
You mentioned that just about 19% of the mothers knew how to use these thermometers correctly. How do you assess how did you assess that point?
Actually, initially we assessed the using a thermometer and type of thermometer. If depending on the type of thermometer, if it is a mercury thermometer, we have asked yes in the during interviewer how do they do the it practically, and same time how do they detect this is a fever, whether they are using that red line or they are actually reading the figure of the temperature. If they are reading the figure of temperature, we will ask the what is the temperature cutout they will take as the fever. So it was done manually.
And also there's one more question.
Speak loud.
Yeah, one more question that so how did you take the sample here? You have taken 400 and something of mothers. So is it from the OPD setup?
No, it is actually for the in ward patients. And
are you selected? Yeah.
Yeah, consecutive patients who are fulfilling our inclusion criteria, like more than 1 month, who has had given paracetamol or any sort of antipyretics at home to prevent the recall bias, and to admit into our ward with a child whose main complaint is fever.
So this is based on only one ward?
Three wards. Three in wards. Teaching hospital Ragama.
Okay. Thank you.
In the absence of further questions, please give a round of applause to the presenter.